Sitting in the morning sun, we'll all be setting when the evening comes. Watching the ships roll in, and then I watch them roll away again. Sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. I left my home in Georgia, headed for the Frisco Bay. Didn't have much to live for, looks like nothing might have come my way. Sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. Looks like nothing's gonna change, everything still remains the same. I can do what 10 people tell me to do, but I guess I'll remain the same. Sitting here resting my bones, but there's loneliness won't leave me alone. 2,000 miles I roam, just to comb this dock my home. Sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time.
So that is Midnight Kitchens, sitting on the dock of the bay. What could be a more appropriate way to start this show? Welcome, everybody, to the January Bay Area Trails Confidential, coming to you from the parking lot in front of a Starbucks near my house, because I lost power about an hour ago and scrambled and figured out a way to get my car out of the garage. And so this is all being powered by a Tesla, which I have some trepidation in admitting that. But we have got a great show for you guys tonight. So I'm really glad that the show does indeed go on, like I said in my email. And we are joined by a couple of really special guests who we're going to hear their whole story. We saw a lot of their pictures in that slideshow. We are brought to you, as always, by San Francisco City Guides, the nonprofit that's been doing tours of San Francisco since 1978. And I do, as always, want to acknowledge that the land we're on is unceded land of different Native American groups who made their home in the Bay Area for many, many generations. And many people from Native American groups continue to live in the Bay Area today. So we should always remember that this was their land and they never gave it to us voluntarily. Tonight's show, we really have one main topic, which is another circumnavigation, this one of the Bay Trail, but by a group that had previously circumnavigated the Ridge Trail. So this is going to be a lot of fun to talk about. I'm going to talk about something I've been doing lately in our second topic. And we'll have time for your question and answers and comments at the end, assuming that my battery does not run out. I think it's doing okay right now. And we always start by showing Bay Trail cred. And Lee, I see, I've got to make Lee, hold on a second, folks. I've got to make Lee give him the ability to unmute. So let me do that. And I don't see Marie yet, but if Marie joins, let me know if Marie joins and I'll make it so she can. So Lee, how are you doing tonight?
Marie is there under the Ridge Trail title.
Oh, she is. Okay, good. Yeah. Marie, well, give me a second to get Marie taken care of. Okay, so Lee, go ahead.
I was just saying, I'm doing great. I love your commitment, Rodney. No storm will ever put this program out.
This isn't half of it. I have COVID right now, so I'm outside the Starbucks because I would not be able to be inside the Starbucks. And I don't have any power. And my country's House of Representatives isn't functioning right now either. So it's like a triple whammy tonight. Sandy Bartlett is with us. Sandy flew back from Chicago to be with us tonight. How are you doing tonight, Sandy?
I'm doing great. And my commitment of flying back in time for the show is nothing compared to what you've done tonight.
Well, I'm the host. I have no choice, right? Oh, I got to say, I think Sarah is wondering where I am right now. So hopefully she figured out I found a safe place to do this. So this is Sandy's Ridge Trail cred from doing the entire Ridge Trail. When did you guys finish that that odyssey?
Let's see, that was June, end of June, 2021. Does that sound right?
So it's been over a year, but then this is what you did just this past
2020.
October.
Was it 2020?
It's hard to even know about these things today, right? With all we've been through in the last couple of years. So this is your Bay Trail cred, and we're going to talk a lot more about that because a lot of this you picked up on your recent circumnavigation. And then Ross, you are returning to Bay Area Trails Confidential. How are you tonight, Ross?
I'm doing well. I have no real arduous journey to get here or anything. I feel like a slacker.
Well, but Ross actually came up with something for me to post in case we needed to cancel tonight's program, which was looking like we were going to have to do, but we didn't. So this is Ross's Ridge Trail cred. And I imagine a lot of this you've done multiple times, right? Right, Ross?
Certainly the South Bay area, we go over more than once. And Sandy and I have started trying to do the opposite, both directions on the Ridge Trail too. So, cause it looks different when you're going the other way.
I'm always intrigued by the operating principles behind these circumnavigations. We're going to talk about that when we get to your topic. This is, you have the same Bay Trail cred as Sandy, cause you were on do you have a little bit more or is it pretty much the same?
I think our Bay Trail is pretty similar.
Yep. Cause you guys just did this and I got to be part of that. I always like to tell you guys what I've been up to. This is what I've done in the last month, which does not look very impressive until you look at what I've done in my local area. And that's going to be my topic. I'm going to talk about this idea of trying to really get to know your neighborhood really well. And this is what I've done over the past year. So kind of my Bay Trail cred. And there's some Ridge Trail in there too. I'm working on that, Marie. Marie, how are you tonight?
I'm doing well. I ventured out and right before the storm and snuggled in at home. So I'm feeling grateful to be in a dry, safe place.
It's actually not even raining right now. Funny enough, at least not yet. We'll update you on that. Don't have a lot of trail updates. It's always fun to point out that the King Tides will be happening later this month. And it was around Christmas time in December. And this is a picture I took over at the Meeker Slough in Richmond. But it's a really interesting time to see the tides. And I know Penny Wells is on. She always wants to point out that you don't just get the super high tides. You also get the super low tides too. So real interesting stuff. This is the other piece of news. So our next show is going to be the second Wednesday of February, not the first Wednesday. I hope Lee and Marie, that's not too much of a surprise for you guys. I needed to reschedule it because of some travel that I'm doing, but we've got an author who's going to be coming on the show who just wrote a novel set in San Francisco. It's really interesting. So just, I'll be putting that in my Friday email, letting you know. Also, we have Lisa Hetler-Smith on tonight. She pointed out that the link I sent in my last email for the February 8th show doesn't work. So I will send out one that does work this Friday. So thank you, Lisa, for catching that. And we are going to talk now about a circumnavigation sequel. So we've got people who previously circumnavigated the Ridge Trail, and now they've gone and done the Bay Trail, and I got to do some of this with them. So Ross and I'm spacing out here.
Sandy
are with us tonight to talk about this. And this is the rest of the group. I do have all your names on a slide. And before you guys did this, I know you kind of did, this isn't your circumnavigation, but you did, this is like a training ride going around the South Bay and over the Dumbarton Bridge. Good way to get you guys ready. And this is what you ultimately did, 340 miles. You noted over 8,000 feet of elevation gain. And it was, I believe, 6 days. Is that right? And included going all the way around the Carquinez Strait. But that's right, Ross, right? 6 days?
A seventh day was that South Bay loop that, you know, was part of the circumnavigation.
Oh, well, you should get credit for that. So 7 days.
It's part of the miles.
It's part of the 340?
Yes.
So that might be my first question to you is like, when you're going to do a circumnavigation, everyone, like some people have this idea, like we're going to always go in the same direction, or we're going to try to go every single place you could possibly go, even if maybe you're not supposed to go certain places. But what were some of the operating principles, Sandy and Ross, that you guys had when you set out to do this adventure?
I'll go first. I think, you know, we wanted to make a circuit. So circumnavigation kind of implies that you're going all the way around. And then, you know, you have, which way do you choose to go around? And, you know, some people that we talked to, you know, said, oh, I've done that. I did it in a day. And it turns out, well, they went around the bay, but they weren't on the Bay Trail. And so our goal was to do as much Bay Trail as we could while we were going around the bay, and especially to try to get every little piece of it when it was far away and we might not easily be able to get back up there.
That's right, Ross. You were very ambitious. You wanted to get as much Bay Trail cred as possible.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's what it's all about.
I take a little bit of credit for that, because that was always my thing, is like let's try to go to as many places as we can. But Sandy, what about you? What were your like ideas behind this? Because you did a lot of, you were kind of the driving force behind this.
Well, I think I probably said, hey, let's ride the Bay Trail around the bay. But I have to give credit to Ross and Sabina, who did the majority of the planning of the trip. They were the ones who really, you know, got the route together. And that wasn't an easy thing to do, because there's a lot of gaps. So they were, you know, had to spend time figuring out the gaps as well. But I think, you know, kind of a driving force too was it, there were just several people who came together who really wanted to do it. And the energy of the group really is what pushed it forward. And we did ride it counterclockwise, which, you know, kind of random draw there. But also, yeah. Rodney, I think a lot of inspiration for this came from watching your programs and you talking about all these incredibly cool places to go to. And I really, you know, I knew the Bay Trail in my area, but I hadn't really explored a lot of other Bay Trail. And so watching your programs, there was a lot of excitement and inspiration to go see these places.
Yeah, and I love that you said that, you know, that's like almost like my trademark. Most people know the Bay Trail or the Ridge Trail near where they live. But you know, what we want to tell them is you want to see the whole thing because it's all different. It's all interesting. So that's great, Sandy. But you were talking about the preparation. Like, what were some of the things you guys did to prepare for this thing?
Well, we did do the one South Bay ride together. That was kind of our training ride to see how well we rode together. And then we did, Ross and Sabina did a lot of the mapping out of the routes. And, you know, other than that, it was really, we're all in relatively good shape already. So, you know, we kind of felt like we had, I know I could have done some more training on my bike specifically, but in general, you know, we all hiked together quite a bit. So we were in good hiking shape, and that helped with the biking. And then really just kind of someone put together a list of things that they would pack. And we added to that as other people thought of things. So that packing list was really helpful to know what to bring with us. And that was a shared list. I don't know, Ross, can you think of anything else we did to prep?
Yeah, I guess it kind of fell into, we had a couple planning things where we, you know, started with picking a date when we could all get enough time off and then how many days. And that kind of drove some of the planning of the route. And then we tried to figure out how much we could do in a day. And then, you know, where we would stay that let us kind of hit that target. We had a target of around 50 miles a day we thought would be comfortable for people. And yeah, had to come up with a route that would do that, which was a little bit challenging.
One thing you guys did that, you know, we talked about was, you know, we talked about safety and I shared my safety map, which includes, you know, kind of rates different parts of the Bay Trail. And noted, first of all, this northern part isn't really officially Bay Trail, but you know, there's no way you guys were going to ride on Highway 37, which is considered like non-completed Bay Trail, although legally you can ride that. My opinion, and I know you guys agree with this, very, very bad idea to bike Highway 37. But even this North Bay, like we did this really nice part through the Carneros region, which is very, very scenic and mellow. But this section from Sonoma to Petaluma, which I had done, you know, we talked about that and you guys said, yeah, you know what? We're not comfortable with that. So, you know, like you guys decided instead that these other, let me see if I can go back to this, these other, these sections, you actually hired somebody to drive you to get.
Yeah, that was them. Probably the hardest part of our planning was figuring out how to get across this gap.
Yeah.
The buses, there are some buses that'll take you from Petaluma to Sonoma, but they only hold two or three bikes. And so there were, you know, potentially six or more of us. And the buses don't run but every 2 hours. So that was a big barrier. And we discovered if you put it into Google and say, oh, get me from Napa to Petaluma, it'll tell you it's a 6-hour trip because it's going to send you on a bus down to Vallejo, a ferry to San Francisco, a ferry to Larkspur, and then the SMART train back up. And so we didn't want to do that if we could avoid it. So there were a lot of gyrations around how to bridge that gap. And you're seeing a picture there of what we finally decided on. We hired Black Sheep Adventures to shuttle us across the gap at about $100 a piece. And that was a worthwhile way to get across, because it let us complete all the way from American Canyon up through Napa and across to Sonoma. We had a nice lunch there and got picked up from the restaurant, Hop Monk in Sonoma. He took us down, and we did where this picture is taken, is the Sears Point little stretch, which is pretty hard to get to, and about, I think, 6 miles long, right? Beautiful section along the bay. And we got to do that. We got a little lost and had to backtrack and redo because we missed a piece of it. And this is right by that horrible two-lane bridge over the Petaluma River where you really can't get through on a bike. So then he shuttled us, you know, continued on from there over to Napa, I'm sorry, Novato, and dropped us off right at the near the Smart Train pathway that continues then down through Belmarine Keys and the Hamilton area. And we were back on nice, safe off-street bay trail for almost the rest of our day, and ended up that day in Terra Linda.
Yeah, so using that, you know, that shuttle was a good way to do it. And it also enabled you to do this one stretch that we're seeing right now, which is, I'm forgetting what that's called. It's Sears Point. I guess it's called the Sears Point Reclamation Area. And now you're not technically supposed to do, so Lee, you may want to avert your eyes here. I don't think this is a functioning, this railroad doesn't get used very much. And it's a very short section you guys did. And then it connects you to a trail. Eventually, I think this is going to get connected. But notice, it's like a little tiny gap.
You'll notice Sabine's way in the front there because she didn't believe that the train was out of service. So she went really fast.
Yeah, she did. And she wasn't even one of the people on e-bikes.
No.
I know like Sandy and a couple of other people had e-bikes. And I thought it was really interesting you guys combined e-bikes with regular bikes. How did that work out? Was that a good way to organize your group?
Yeah, it actually worked out really well. There were definitely some pretty strong riders in our group, and I think that e-bikes allowed certain people to be able to keep up with them, you know, and make it a little bit more enjoyable and not like completely wear us out. So we didn't really use the e-bikes continuously. Like we tried to ride and then use the e-bikes when we needed them. So it was a great way, like, you know, if I felt like I was falling behind the group, I could catch up easily and then turn the electrical power off and just ride my bike like a regular bike. So it actually worked out just fine. It worked out, I think, really well for us.
Yeah, it's kind of an equalizer. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if you've got a group of friends and some are really experienced cyclists and some maybe aren't, if you can, I don't know if you can rent an e-bike for a period, or of course, if you have an e-bike, then it really enables you to do a lot more. Marie, I know you've got an e-bike. Have you ridden with other friends that are on regular bikes?
You know, mostly I use it for commuting. And so I haven't done a lot of distance with others, but I have actually done the reverse where I've gone on my regular bike and somebody's used the e-bike to try to just do, you know, balance things out. And I think it works on so many levels. Yeah, I think it's great. A great new tool we have in our tool belt.
Yeah.
Adventures.
Absolutely. And you know, I've talked about this. I really want to do a show about e-bikes sometime in the next few months. You know, just because I have very positive feelings about them. I know there's some concerns about, you know, people riding fast around pedestrians, but all in all, I think they're a big plus. But back to you, Ross and Sandy. So what were some of the surprises? What were some of the things that you encountered that really, you know, taught you new things about the Bay Area region?
One of the things I noticed was, was kind of when we got off the Bay Trail and went through like Emeryville, was how much upgraded infrastructure there is of the streets accommodating bikes that I hadn't seen since I hadn't really visited some of those more dense urban areas. And that was refreshing to see.
Yeah, so it's like, you know, this is happening all over the place, but you know, many of these places we only go to occasionally. So it's kind of a very pleasant surprise when you see new bike and pedestrian infrastructure. What about you, Sandy? What were some of the surprises for you?
I don't know if it was so much of a surprise as just kind of it was just a delight to see everywhere we went how much people loved their piece of the bay that they used. You know, they just everywhere we went, there are people walking dogs, people riding bikes, people walking hand in hand, people, you know, pushing strollers, running. And it just made me realize how much like the bay means to people. What a place it is, you know, it's a place to go to relax, to enjoy nature, to connect. And it was just everywhere we went, people were there just enjoying their part of the bay.
Yeah. And, you know, and it's like we go through all kinds of different areas, you know, different economic groups, for example, and you just see the different, the Bay Trail is the thing that we all have in common, you know, different groups of people flock to it. And it is like this thing that we all have in common.
It's neat to see as we're out there here, you know, for 6 days doing this, cruising around. And wherever we went, you know, you'd see certain places that were really heavily used. And it was these people's go-to escape area to get out on the trail. And we were just getting, you know, passing through. But for other people, that's their home court area.
Yep. That's it. You're right. This is because most people are really going to the parts of the bay and the ridge trail near them. And you guys did this thing, and it was a, you know, 7 day trip. And for six of those days, it was continuous. So how is that for like, traveling around the Bay Area, finding accommodations? You know, you guys were on bike, it'd probably be more challenging on foot, but how did that work out?
Yeah, we spent the first night in an Airbnb, which worked out great that, you know, you were there and your wife joined us for dinner that night. And that was really fun. And then the rest of the nights we decided to stay in hotels. It made it easy to stay in a hotel where we had breakfast in the mornings. So we didn't have to get, you know, we could get up, go down, have breakfast. But it worked out really well for us to have like a good night's rest and a shower at the end of the day in the hotels rather than camping. Camping would have been fun, but the hotels were nice to do. So that worked out really well. It was, you know, like Ross had said earlier, we kind of planned that 50 miles a day and booked the hotels ahead of time. So that was the goal every day, was to get to that spot where we were spending the night.
So that was a good number. Go ahead, Ross.
Oh, I was just going to say, we found at least two hotels that were right on Bay Trail too, at the Brisbane Marina area and up in Smith Ranch and Marin.
You guys had, and this is actually part of it, I think, this is on the Carquinez Strait, right?
Yeah, that was in Venetia.
Excited about the thrifty ice cream. But I was actually talking to Lisa Hetler-Smith earlier today. She really wants to do a multi-day adventure on the bay, somewhere in the Bay Area on foot. And I was thinking like the Carquinez Strait is kind of ideal for that. And I know you guys had a really good experience there. So like what were your takeaways about the Carquinez Strait area?
Well, one of the, we kind of tied that in. There's a Ridge Trail board member, Bob Berman, who lives in Benicia, and he runs a little Carquinez Strait scenic loop trail tour periodically, maybe as often as once a month during like the nice weather. And it's kind of a cool area because it's where the Ridge Trail and the Bay Trail come together. There's some pretty long sections that are where you're on both Ridge Trail and Bay Trail, including the I don't know if the Benicia Bridge is Bay Trail, but the Carquinez Bridge is both Bay Trail and Ridge Trail. So a whole bunch of that loop is mixed, or is both. So you get double credit for doing the miles there. There's Paul Furman in the middle. Used this as a tie up point where we met up and with these other people and rode with them for the day. And it was Port Costa was kind of the highlight of the day because it's this really cool town. The Port Costa, I don't know if it's what the official name of it is, but it's a pub bar down at the bottom of the hill on the water. And it's got all this old like movie memorabilia. People from Mountain View might have known St. James Infirmary. Felt like the same kind of feel with all sorts of funky stuff in it. And kind of as an extra highlight, we're sitting out on enjoying the nice weather and on the kind of patio out there. And all of a sudden the silence is broken. And I think probably 200 motorcycles came roaring down, Harleys and everything. Half the people are in costumes. It was just like a complete motorcycle takeover of the place. and a lot of people in Halloween gear. It was really fun.
Yeah, you guys did this right around Halloween. And I know you guys had some of your own costumes. So it was kind of part of the fun. So speaking of the Ridge and the Bay Trail, since you guys have circumnavigated them both, how do you compare the two? Like what are some of the things that you thought about when you were encountering the Bay Trail, comparing it to the Ridge Trail?
Boots, do you want to?
Well, I mean, one thing I noticed, I think the Ridge Trail is really well, the signs are really well done. Like it's easy to, know where you're going. The Ridge Trail signs are always there. There's far fewer signs on the Bay Trail. And so it was a little more difficult to really know that we were on the Bay Trail.
It's a little more challenging. I mean, maybe that makes it more, the overcoming that challenge is kind of part of the fun, makes it more of an accomplishment.
Yeah.
It's also a Bay Trail, you guys are on bikes. You'd have a hard time biking the entire Ridge Trail. In fact, you're not allowed to. I think there's sections where you're not really supposed to, right?
Yeah. Well, when you're on Ridge Trail, you also expect elevation. I mean, you're hiking ridges. I kind of had it in my mind that Bay Trail was going to be pretty flat because we're by the bay. And that was true for many sections, but certainly not all the sections. I was really surprised by the amount of elevation that we did.
Yeah. And we have that one picture of you guys pretty worn out. Do you guys remember what section that was that really had you pretty tired at the end of the day?
I'm guessing it might have been after that hill up out of Rodeo. And we stopped at a little overlook of the Carquinez Bridge.
Yeah.
There were a couple other notable hills along the way. And the Carquinez Loop, Scenic Loop Trail, certainly had a fair amount of up and down on the southern side. So don't be prepared for that and take your time. Don't expect
to rush to Port
Costa.
So this is funny, this day, your last day was kind of some early season rain, I guess maybe a harbinger of things to come, but you guys had to deal with some wet conditions and kind of makes us think of today. You certainly wouldn't want to be riding in the current conditions. But even then you guys look like you were having a really good time. would you guys say there was a favorite day of the ride? If you had to pick, I can bring up your map.
Well, that day wasn't a bad day. It was drizzly in the morning and we knew there was a front coming through. And we got pretty lucky, really, because it was like a 2-hour band of heavy rain that passed through, and you showed that little radar image. That was while we were at Hobie's in the middle of it. And it rained really, really hard, started really quickly, and caught us kind of by surprise.
Yeah, this looks like
cleared up, and by the end of the day, we were in sunshine.
Yeah.
We were, fortunately, we were near a Hobie's. So, although a little planned, because we knew when the storm was coming in, but Hobie's happened to be close by, and their warm cinnamon tea was perfect because we were all a little bit wet and cold at that point.
It's good to have places to stop when it's raining out.
Yeah.
So do you guys have plans for what's the next adventure you might be doing?
Well, we're working on the Ridge Trail in the opposite direction.
And so yeah, about Tahoe Rim Trail.
Tahoe Rim Trail, yeah.
Getting out of your cars. Yeah, and then, of course, you guys started off on the Stevens Creek Trail, which I know, Ross, you've been involved with the Friends of the Stevens Creek for a long time, right?
Yeah, going on 20-plus years now. And you see here, it joins to the Bay Trail as well, which was my early start with the Bay Trail. And then at the other end, it joins up with the Ridge Trail. So it's one of the, you know, small number of regional connector trails that connects both of them together.
Maybe we need to do a whole show about the Stevens Creek Trail, Ross, at some point.
I would not
suggest opposed. Connect today on the Ridge Trail.
Our active project right now is, you know, it's got a number of little sections all along the way. It's about 25 miles from the bay up to the ridge. And there's maybe 15 miles of it built with little gaps. And so we've been recently just getting new trail insignia put up that, if I can get it to be in focus, to identify the Stevens Creek Trail. And so we're putting those up in Mountain View right now. Local people will start seeing them. They're up in Stevens Creek County Park and up in the Montebello, the top of by the Ridge Trail.
Well, let's definitely publicize that, Ross. Let's get everybody, you know, I haven't done the entire, you know, I've done the Bay Trail, but I haven't done the Stevens Creek Trail. And of course, I still need to do the entire Ridge Trail. That's going to be my big challenge, I think. Well, last thing I just wanted to thank you guys for is you guys just had so many awesome photographs, which is always appreciated, you know, of all kinds of things. So like, this is like the perfect use of duct tape. You know, but also I love the way you guys are always posing for these photos. And one of the things when I put the show together, I really want lots of great images to show people. And you guys, I don't even know, like many hundreds of photos to pick from. So thanks for that. And also thank you for inviting me along. I had a really good time with you guys. Really nice group you guys have.
Oh, it was awesome to have our own private guide to get us through Pinole and some of the difficult places.
I mean, that's what's fun is you do have to like find, you know, it's like you have to gain that knowledge, and then it's fun to show other people. So that's what I like about the Bay. And this is, by the way, we found this, this is right near the Brooklyn Basin. It says my internet connection's unstable. Are you guys hearing me okay?
You warbled out a little bit.
Warbled
a minute ago, but
again, you know, I'm doing my best here in front of the Starbucks. I'm just really happy that we were able to do this show, and thank you so much, Ross and Sandy, for coming on to talk about this. And I hope you'll stick around at the end. We'll be seeing if we have questions or thoughts from people in the audience.
Yeah, and I just want to mention one more thing. There was kind of a core group of people that did the whole ride, but we had friends joining us for various pieces, like Rodney was there on certain days. And so, you know, if anyone is going to plan a trip like this, it is nice to just like have people join you along the way. They can come for a day or a couple of days. And it was really nice to have that, like those friends joining us. It was really made the trip really that much more fun.
Here's the list of the folks. Was there anybody else that well, you had Bob Berman, I know, in addition. But yeah, it is kind of fun. Like, you can be like this traveling road show and then pick up friends around the Bay Area. So it's another way, like, to think of ourselves as a region is, you know, we've got different friends in different parts of the region, and it's great to have an activity that brings people together. And maybe I'll make that my last question. Yeah,
I was just going to say, you can take public transit to get to almost anywhere in the Bay, almost. And, you know, meet up or go home early from an adventure like this.
So doing these circumnavigations, does that make you think differently? You think of the Bay Area region, like, now that you've had these two experiences? And if so, how?
Oh, yeah. It is so much fun now whenever I'm going somewhere to think, you know, if I look towards the Bay, I know what's between the freeway and the Bay because I've ridden it. And if I look, you know, up in the ridge, I know what's up there because I've walked it. So it's just really exciting to really get closer to nature in all parts around the Bay Area, and to just really understand what's there. And just, I don't know, connecting the dots is really fun, to just have, you know, see how the trails come together and carry us from one area to another. It's amazing.
Yeah, it really helps us understand, like, the geography. You know, these aren't just places that you drive to on an interstate highway. You know, these are places that kind of have a relationship to one another. We've got 3 million people living here in the Bay Area, and you get to really get a better sense of what these different places are like. Any last thoughts from Ross or Sandy?
Just, it's amazing. I think both trails are amazing. It's just, I'm so grateful to all of the people that worked so hard to put these together for us. And, you know, I highly recommend either the Bay Trail or the Ridge Trail. They're both fantastic.
You know, I think you're right, Sandy, but it's only the Bay Trail has Segway polo going on. I don't think it's happening so much on the Ridge Trail. Okay, well, thank you guys both. And I'm going to move on to my next topic. And, you know, my next topic, it's just something I've been doing over the past month, because I'm always trying to think of something to do. And I think it actually relates to what you, Ross, and Sandy just did. There's a certain why to this. Like, why would you take the time to circumnavigate the Bay Trail or the Ridge Trail? And you guys, I think, have told us, you know, that it really helps you understand our region better. But I decided this month to try to, like, walk all the streets of my area, which is Kensington. I'm kind of in an interesting area, which is, like, right at the bottom of the Berkeley Hills. And so I just basically, most of the roads within a mile of my house, I walked. And here, this gives you a sense of the different excursions I did. And it really, you know, I've lived here for 25 years, but I mean, this area, and I think I know it really well, but I got to know it a lot better over the past month by doing all this and seeing, you know, all the different neighborhoods. One thing, it was like a perfect time of year to do it, because I got to see everybody's Christmas lights, you know, and see, like, which are the streets that have really, really awesome sets of Christmas lights. And also, this time of year, you get to see, well, what are the neighborhoods that have drainage problems? Might be something going on tonight. You know, thinking about, like, this is actually a really big deal. Like, where does the water go? And you do get to see some of that walking around. And I was kind of inspired by one of my favorite films, a film I saw before I started doing Bay Area Trails Confidential. It's a documentary called The World Before Your Feet. And it's basically this guy, Matt Green, who decided to walk every single street in New York City. And it's like 8,000 miles. And he really, really got to know New York City in a special way by doing that. It's a great documentary. You can stream it from a number of the different streaming services for just a few bucks. So I highly recommend that. But it really inspired me to do that. And then Ross, I was telling you what I did when we were preparing for the show, and you mentioned to me that there's this website called Every Single Street, run by a guy named Ricky Gates, who has run every single street in San Francisco. And then he's got photo essays of various sorts of San Francisco, but he's also compiled other people who have done similar things in different cities all over the world. And so, you know, we always spotlight a place on this show, but the place I'm spotlighting tonight is going to be your neighborhood. I think you should try to do something similar to what I did in my neighborhood, in your neighborhood, try to like walk all of it and just really get to see it all at that level. You know, I think one of the things we've talked about in the show is that to experience places in a car is not the same as what you're going to do when you're seeing it on foot or on a bike. You really get a much more intimate understanding of where you live when you do that. It also did turn out to be a good project for me this month because I ended up getting COVID. So I really couldn't stray very far from where I live. Tried to stay away from people and did not go inside anything while I was doing all this. But there's that advantage too, that it's all very close by and you don't have to get on public transit to go to these places. But that's kind of like my challenge to everybody in 2023 is try to get out and see a lot more of your neighborhood on foot. Maybe try to be complete like this. You know, I'm kind of showing off the tracking devices that so many of us have. But it is fun to see, like, have I really covered all the different streets? And I think I have. So that's kind of what I've been up to. We have a Serena selection every month. And this month's Serena selection is Tiburon, which is a great place to visit. And of course, the Tiburon Ferry goes there. Didn't really have a contest that I came up with tonight, but I had an idea that I could use a number generator and just pick somebody at random in the audience and ask them a quiz question. And if you win, you will get either the Bay Trail map cards or the Ridge Trail guide. So give me a second here. I'm going to pick somebody at random. And if they answer, so they're going to be the ninth person in my list of people. Charlotte Payne, are you able? Try unmuting Charlotte if you don't mind, and if you want to be a contestant in tonight's show to win the Bay Trail map cards or the Ridge Trail guide. So Charlotte,
I'll try.
All right, this is gonna be a pretty hard question, Charlotte. Are you ready for this?
No.
Okay, it's going to really, really challenge your knowledge of the Bay Area region. I want you to name a city or town on either the Bay or the Ridge Trail that is a county seat.
Oh, good. Let's see. San Mateo?
San Mateo. Well, I don't think it is San Mateo for San Mateo County. Am I right? Maybe I'm wrong. Hold on a second. Let me double check that.
It's Redwood City. Yeah.
Charlotte, you want to take a second guess? You get two guesses in this game. Pick another city.
Santa Clara. Or no, San Jose. Sorry.
Is San Jose this county seat of San Jose County or Santa Clara County?
I have no idea.
The county seat is San Jose. Charlotte, you are a winner. Good, because I didn't really have another question to ask somebody.
And I had no other answers, so we're good.
All right. Well, congratulations, Charlotte.
Thank you.
And where, what part of the Bay, or what, well, I'm making an assumption there. What part of the world are you coming to us from?
Sunnyvale.
Sunnyvale, that is in the Bay Area.
Yeah.
And I guess I'll send you an email and you can think about whether you want the Ridge Trail Guide, which is a really great guide with in-depth descriptions of all the sections of the Ridge Trail, or the coveted Bay Trail map cards. So think about that and we will send them to you. Want to thank folks for sending in or for providing photos, and it's all the people that basically were part of this this Bay Trail circumnavigation. So thank you guys very much. Again, I want to point out that our next show is not going to be the first Wednesday of February. It's going to be the second Wednesday of February. And we have an author who's written a detective novel set in San Francisco. He doesn't live in San Francisco. And that's kind of how I got to know him. He wanted me to take him on a private guided tour of Bayview Hunters Point because he'd written about it, but he'd actually never been there. And he's a really interesting guy, and it's a very interesting book. And it's being published this month, but I got an advanced copy, and I will definitely recommend it. I will end the show as we do the official part of the show with happy trails, and then we'll do any questions or comments you guys have to make. So here we go.
Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep smiling until then. Who cares about the clouds if we're together? Just sing a song and bring the sunny weather. Happy trails to you until we meet again. Until we meet again.
Hopefully the next time we meet, I'll have power and I'll be able to do this from my house with my green screen and everything. I thank you guys for putting up with whatever I look like in my car right now. That's the wrong slide. We do have show notes, and it's jan23.baytrailconfidential.com. I'll go ahead and put that in chat for you guys. It'll also be in the email that I send you tomorrow with the survey and in my Friday email. But now I want to open it up. And first of all, I want to ask if Lee or Marie, do you guys have any comments on anything in the show tonight? Because I didn't call on you guys too much.
No, I'm just glad that they were able to go out there. All of you were able to kind of enjoy it. And yeah, there are some challenging spaces because the trail's not complete right now. But I'm glad you guys were able to figure it out because it can be tough in some of those spaces. And I forgot who said it about the Bay Trail having some elevation in some areas. And absolutely, the vast majority of it's going to be on the shoreline and pretty flat, as most people imagine. But there are some spaces like the Kirkina Strait area where there's just nowhere to put it but on the bluffs. So these are all things people need to know. And I'm glad you guys are able to share your experiences with them.
Yeah, and I think together we can really make the experience easier for people, you know, by sharing this knowledge. And Marie, I got to ask you, Marie, are you, you know, we took one of your Ridge Trail board members and this group of people that had previously done the Ridge Trail and put them on the Bay Trail. Are you okay with that?
Oh, of course. Absolutely. As Ross said, you know, one of the great things is when we're connecting together and every bridge that we cross the Bay is both Bay Trail or almost all of them, Bay Trail and Ridge Trail. I was really inspired. I have, I've done road cycling a lot in the past, and I have good friends that go, you know, all over the place. And I thought, why aren't we doing the Bay Trail? And we don't have to necessarily do it for a week, but to really think about doing multi-day adventures. Certainly with cycling, road cycling, it's possible on the Bay Trail, but you know, on both, it's possible for hiking, and you can do mountain bike. A lot of people do bike packing on the Ridge Trail, and they'll take, it's a much more urban wild adventure. You know, you're going to be up in parks and versus definitely encountering more of a urban city experience on the Bay Trail. But I think they both have that element of wild. And there are, we actually have on our website a couple of little routes that you can choose that are really great, like weekend or 3 or 4 day excursions. So I would encourage people to look at both trails as opportunities to get to go on really multi-day adventures right in your own backyard with
transit. I totally agree.
Transit.
Totally agree, Marie. And I think we want to talk more about multi-day adventures. I want to do a show that focuses specifically on the Carquinez Strait on foot. So that really is Ridge Trail on the Carquinez Strait. And you can, of course, get to it on an Amtrak or like a bus that connects with BART. So lots of ways of getting there. Well, thanks, Marie, Lee. Do we have folks in the audience who, I should make it so you guys can unmute. If anyone wants to unmute and ask a question. Hold on, give me a second.
Rodney, before we get into that, there are a couple of questions in the chat. I think that Ross did a great job of answering most of them, but I think there were a couple that I was tracking that we need to ask you, I think.
Okay.
One of them was, can you share the safety map?
Yeah, I can share the safety map. I think it isn't on my website. So I'll put it on my website and I will put a link to that in my Friday email. Because I do want to share that. Although I do want to caution people that that is my opinion, and you might want to like check with other people, but I do think like the places that I'm saying are to be really careful about. I don't think there's gonna be a lot of debate about that.
I think you're absolutely right about that, Rodney. Sense of safety is very subjective.
It is, and I'm a pretty experienced cyclist who has ridden a lot in places with high speed traffic, but nevertheless, my preference is very much to be away from that.
Got it. And one last question is that Serena asked, what's the app that you use to track your travels?
I use Strava, and then Strava, you can upload to this Relive site that creates those nifty little, videos. Although I had to trick it because that was like multiple different Strava segments, and I had to use this tool that combined different GPX files, very nerdy stuff, you know. But hey, gotcha. There's nothing I won't do to like, wow this audience, right?
That's absolutely right. I was just about to say, you may be the first person who's ever done an online program through a Tesla.
You don't tell Elon Musk. He'll probably want a piece, you know.
Maybe. So that's it. So I guess we'll go to audience.
Yeah. Thank you, Lee. We always want to like engage you guys in the audience. And I'm going to try to think in this year of ways of doing more of that, doing maybe more polls and different ways of like, you know, getting more input from folks. But yeah, anyone out there in the audience want to ask a question or make a statement or talk about your own circumnavigation, your own goals? We are not a large group, so if you just want to unmute and say something, feel free to go ahead.
Hi, this is Martha Branch, and I wanted to say that I had the privilege of joining Ross and Sandy on one of the days for the Bay Trail, and it was really wonderful. And as Sandy mentioned, there was this really special dynamic group energy that was happening that day. And I suspect that it snowballed as the progressive days went on for riding together, but it was really such a positive, fun, super fun group. And I think that that's really part of what made this particular group such a success, was that there was this really great dynamic going on.
Yeah.
It was, and I had a blast. To be around.
Well, thanks, Martha. And I totally agree with you. It was a real joy to be around these guys, and everyone was having just a great time. And you can kind of see like these guys really, let me see if I can find some of these photos. These guys really hammed it up a lot in these photos, which I enjoyed. Oh, did I like totally screw up my thing? hold on. But I know there's a lot of really fun photos. And I think I'm gonna like take that slideshow and maybe if you guys are okay with it, we could upload it to YouTube or something. But yeah, where are some of the really well the one I'm trying to think, there's some good ones at the Golden Gate Bridge, and actually right in the very beginning. Like this is a good sense of the group. Like stuff like that. Everyone was always like waving their hands and oh, actually, I don't know if we saw this. The really great one was at the Albany Bulb. Let's see if we can find that. The Albany. Did I somehow manage to not? What did I do with the Albany Bulb? Give me a second here, because those are fun. I'll find them. Any other thoughts, Martha? Were there any surprises or fun things you learned on the experience?
You know, it was fun. We were at a park. Do you remember this? And they were changing the dedication name. And here we are. We drive up and there's like a news conference going. And And they had a big chocolate cake that we kept talking about. They were going to try to get some cake on the way out. But the random things that you see, that's really makes it fun.
Am I remembering correctly that it was being named for Pete Stark? Is that the correct name?
I think so. Eden Landing was becoming Pete Stark.
Whenever we go there and we see the Pete Stark name, we'll know we were there at this. You know, it was all these people in suits and stuff.
Yeah.
And we really thought, like, we're like citizens, right? There should be some cake for us, but there wasn't.
Like I'm rolling up in all our gear.
That's right. And Martha, you did that day ride and then you had to get back.
Yes. And I got to my car in time. It didn't get impounded down there.
And Martha was riding an acoustic bike.
Oh. Acoustic
bike. So you're in this picture, aren't you?
Yeah. I am. I'm on the way far right.
That's it.
Yeah. I was on a road bike.
Well, I'm really glad you could tune in tonight, Martha.
Yeah, some of
the
others
in the group weren't free tonight, including like Joel Gartland, who has been a guest on past shows. But we've got the recording. They'll be able to see what we were able to do from a Starbucks parking lot. I first for Bay Area Trails Confidential. Any other folks out there want to say something, ask a question, throw down a challenge for 2023? Go ahead.
Ronnie, hi. Hi, guys. This is Lisa from San Jose.
Hi, Lisa.
Yeah. So actually, I'm a walker. And I'm very passionate about the idea of finding ways to walk for 2 days one night, 3 days two nights or more, and staying kind of at the end of the day and wherever you end up, and then going to the next and staying, carrying a very light pack because you're staying in places, you're not camping. I'm not a backpacker. And I've kind of tried to find ways to do this on the Rich Trail, and it doesn't, so far, I haven't figured that out. I think there's probably more likelihood of doing it on the Bay Trail because it's more urban and there's more places to stay. But what I would love, I've done it, I have a bunch of routes that I've done already, but I'd love to get people's ideas who are locals to places that they know better, like what, you know, what's there, where you can either take public transport or drive and leave your car safely somewhere and then walk from there and walk and walk and eventually even Uber back. Because, you know, when you're a walker, you can't get that far in a couple of days. Like it's not that expensive to Uber back, even if you've walked for 3 days, right? So I don't know whether, you know, it'd be fun to start a spreadsheet where people can contribute and make suggestions. Basically, you know, place where you park or how you get to the beginning, and then how, and I'm talking about walking sort of maybe 8 to 10 miles a day, not super far. That sounds like a lot maybe as a walker, but if that's all you have to do in a day, that's not that far. and where there's places to stop and eat, or you know, and where you stay, that kind of thing. And then how do you get back? You can, if, as long as you can get cell service, you can Uber back to wherever you started if you have to. I would love to sort of engage in that conversation. I'm not quite sure how to do that. And maybe get people's ideas about that.
I think this group can be kind of a good clearinghouse for that. And maybe we can, you know, get some of these things documented to some degree on the website. You know, what kind of multi-day adventures can you do on foot? What can you do on bike, maybe even by kayak? I see we have Penny in the audience. Penny's done, you've done that on the water trail. So, you know, yeah, I think that's a great idea.
It's just nice to share that information because we have such a rich, the Greater Bay Area is so wealthy in all of these kinds of opportunities. It's just a matter of putting it together and just, I mean, Rodney, you and I could talk more about maybe to figure out where there's a platform that people like could crowdsource some of this information, and I can help to create even the you know, what would be the categories, like how would you, what information would you need to put in there? But to me, as much, I used to be a biker for a long time, and I think that for me, the idea of promoting walking is that anybody can do that almost. Like there's a lot of people who can't bike or don't want to bike or feel uncomfortable with that. They worry the bike will break and they don't know what to do with it. For those people who would be happy to put, you know, 8 pounds on their back and walk, I think it's a fantastic way to get people out and moving and seeing these places that otherwise might not. They might not hike, they might not backpack, they might not bike a long way, but they can walk 6 miles.
Well,
you know,
I think the gauntlet's been thrown down.
Yes.
I'd like to document one of these things. The one that really comes to my mind is the Carquinez Strait.
Yes.
So that may be one that maybe we
could work on that
in 2023. So great. Thanks, Lisa. Any other folks out there have thoughts, questions? Otherwise, this is a first. The first, you know, we really thought we were going to have to cancel this program because my power, as far as I know, the power is still not on. And I have to say, Sarah's probably figured out that I was able to find a decent internet connection to be able to do the show. But I'm really glad you guys were able to join us tonight. Especially want to thank Sandy and Ross. Great having you guys talking about your adventure. I'm really thrilled I got, and Martha too. Thank you, Martha. And then Lee and Marie, always thank you for being part of this. So I think we will call it a wrap, and want to wish everybody well and just remind you once again, we'll be back in February, but not on February 1st, but on February the 8th, the second Wednesday of February.
Thanks, Rodney.
Happy New Year, everybody.
Thanks. Happy New Year. I'm pretty sure my Tesla has enough battery power to get me home. The only question is whether my garage door is going to operate or not. We'll see. Anyway, everyone have a good night.
Be safe.
Thanks. Bye. You too. Bye.
Thanks.